Welcome to Snap-on Training Solutions. This module is designed to help you get the most out of your VERUS Pro diagnostic tool and covers the use of global OBD-II scanner functions. Global OBD scanner coverage is strictly related to emissions-related coverage and is universal in that all vehicles sold in the U.S. and Canada since 1996 must comply with this standard. All 10 modes of OBD-II are covered by this tool and accessed by selecting the OBD Direct icon on the home screen. All service modes are not supported by all vehicles, so the available menu selections will vary. Let's start by exploring the OBD Direct functions. This opens a menu of two choices, OBD Diagnose and OBD Health Check. OBD Health Check allows you to perform a quick check of OBD-II codes and readiness monitors. For this demonstration, we will select OBD Diagnose to diagnose a vehicle. We see the following options. Start communication initiates a test session. Select communication protocol establishes which vehicle protocol to use. Let's select connector information to see where to find the data link connector or DLC on this vehicle. Let's choose an Alfa Romeo. Some of these models may not be familiar in the US, but all vehicles are included in Global OBD-II, so you always know you have emissions coverage on any vehicle. Let's select model 147. Here's the connector location. Have you ever searched for a connector that was not in the usual place? The DLC locator makes it easy. Coverage includes all 10 modes of OBD-II and readiness monitors, which are very important when verifying emission repairs. Readiness monitors provide a status report on emissions-related systems. Some monitor reports require an extensive drive cycle in order to complete the requirements of the test. The screen presents two choices, monitors complete since DTC cleared and monitors complete this cycle. Let's look at the monitors complete this cycle. Results are shown for each monitor, if the monitor is supported by the vehicle, and whether the drive cycle test is complete for each monitor. All monitor tests must be complete in order for the vehicle to be ready for an emissions test. What's this? Troubleshooter for Global OBD-II? You bet! Snap-on Troubleshooter consists of expert tips from OEM and specialty technicians. OBD-II tips pertain specifically to engine and emission systems. Select Fast Track Troubleshooter. Then select Tests and Procedures. Select Drive Cycle Procedures. Troubleshooter shows the drive cycle procedures for a fast way to complete readiness monitor tests. Troubleshooter code tips can save significant diagnostic time by giving you the likely causes for a specific fault code. Select Code Tips. Select P0XXX DTC Tip Lists. Then P0503. This tip on a vehicle speed sensor code shows likely causes that might not be obvious, like instrument panel or wiring issues. Let's take a brief look at the valuable information available in each of the 10 modes in OBD-II. Mode 1 displays live data parameters for engine and emission systems. This is typically your first step when diagnosing a check engine light. Mode 2 displays freeze frame data. This is a record of vehicle data parameters captured at the moment a fault code was set. This can give valuable insight into the operating conditions of the vehicle at the time of the fault. Mode 3 displays the OBD-II trouble codes currently set by the vehicle. OBD-II fault codes are standard for every vehicle manufacturer. The code definition is also shown on the right to explain the meaning of the code. Remember to look at Troubleshooter for useful insight into the likely causes of each code. Mode 4 provides an easy method to turn off the malfunction indicator lamp, or MIL, after a repair. Caution, this also clears freeze frame data, pending codes, and readiness monitors. So this should usually be the last step in your repair process. Modes 5, 6, and 7 display data parameters related to oxygen sensors, saved results of manufacturer-specific tests, and trouble codes detected during the last drive cycle. This is useful in determining the root cause of recurring fault codes. Here are your Mode 5 test results, your Mode 6 results, and your Mode 7 results. Mode 8 allows a service technician to invoke an onboard test to seal the evaporative system for a pressure test. This function varies by manufacturer. For example, on Ford systems, this closes the canister vent solenoid for 10 minutes. Mode 9 can read the calibration and ID numbers for the engine control unit, or ECU, or the vehicle identification number, or VIN. Mode 9 performance tracking displays a record of the number of times each of the readiness monitors have been completed. Remember, for easy navigation, you can use the back icon at any time to step back one screen and the home icon as a shortcut to the main menu. Snap-on is dedicated to helping you get the most out of your diagnostic tool and keep your customers happy. Click here to watch the next module in this training solutions series. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss the next great product from Snap-on.